On the show, Soumya clicks some pictures. Kabir clicks some pictures. Soumya goes to sleep. TMI returns to the How To studio. Let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen.
What? What is it?
Tonight.
What?
We welcome you to How To, where we tell you a lot of stuff that you can do with technology, some new stuff and really cool stuff.
That's true. So what are we doing?
One second. Nobody asked me. I ask people. All right? One second.
Personality disorder.
One second.
Okay.
We are going to teach you how to go about taking your first DSLR. How about buying it for the first time? Okay? That's what we are going to answer tonight.
Okay. Calm down. Let's take a look at this how-to.
All right, so before we go ahead and tell people how to pick up your first DSLR,
yep.
The biggest question is, do people actually know what is a DSLR?
No, the answer to that question is no. I don't think people even know what is the full form of what it stands for.
So, in that case, we shall tell people
what
exactly the DSLR technology is.
Yep.
And what is the full form of DSLR.
Yes.
And then I'll demand $1,000 again.
DSLR stands for Digital Single Lens Reflex. DSLRs have built-in mirrors or reflex, so the image you see bounces up to the viewfinder. DSLR uses interchangeable lenses, and that is the beauty of this gadget. One gets to see innovative, creative, and new views each time. Before we get into picking your first DSLR, it's important to think carefully. Do you really need one? A word from the wise.
I think it's very important for a first-time buyer to first try and understand why is he buying a DSLR. Is he just buying a DSLR because it's a DSLR? You know, it's that brand value that owning a DSLR suddenly makes people feel that they're serious photographers. If that's the case, I would actually tell them don't. But if you are serious about making images in the long run and you feel you need a good camera for that, then just see what comes in your budget. That's obviously a very important consideration.
Even after this, if your answer is yes, then let's get started.
All right, dekho ab aap kitna show off kar sakte apne friends ke saath. Oye, dekho DSLR ka full form aata hai ya nahi aata hai?
Kabir, I just realized the camera that I'm holding, it's worth 1,60,000 something.
Good point. And that's our first point. When you go out buying your first DSLR, the first thing that you need to take care of or be aware of is
not have a heart attack looking at the prices.
What is your budget? Heart attack to baad mein hoga na.
Budget.
DSLR costs can be very overwhelming. They range from ₹30,000 and can go into lakhs. But just because it is expensive does not mean it is better. If you're buying for the first time, here is a budget you can keep in mind.
For a first-time buyer, I think a budget of 30 to 40,000 rupees is good enough. That's because your DSLR would usually cost you 30. Anything in the 30 to 32 range is good. The rest of the money, you obviously need memory cards. In the entry-level segment, Nikon cameras have significantly better image quality. So something like the Nikon D3300 or even the older D3200, which I think is still available for a lesser price, are very good cameras to buy. Canon 1200D, I believe, always goes on this nice offer with a couple of lenses for really cheap. So at the end of the day, you can't go wrong with either one of them.
The second point when you are buying your first DSLR is, what is the purpose of your DSLR?
The purpose of the DSLR.
Keanu Reeves had a purpose in Matrix. Every DSLR has a purpose.
Yes.
So we are going to talk about that before you go ahead and buy your first DSLR.
Yeah.
Are you buying a DSLR for family vacations, weddings, birthdays or get-togethers? Or are you planning to take up photography as a hobby or a career? This is an important question. For the former,
if you do believe that photography is your calling as a career, not just as something you love doing, then yes, it starts becoming important. Then you start asking yourself that, do you spend a little extra? Instead of 30, do you spend 50? And maybe get a camera which is a mid-level camera, for instance.
The big thing that you will face when you're buying your first DSLR is which brand. Now, I have been a Nikon user for about 4 years.
And I'm an honest and a loyalist when it comes to Canon.
Yeah, but how did we come about choosing these brands? Well, the first thing to consider is the ecosystem that the brand is providing you.
She's just dropping big words. Ecosystem. Aapki duniya ecosystem hila degi.
Can you just...
We're talking about accessories, right?
Yeah, ecosystem. Accessories and the paraphernalia that comes with it, okay?
Tomorrow
and
will never come because of ecosystem.
Okay, ho gaya.
Today, there are two major players when it comes to DSLRs. That does make it a little easy. But then again, both give you great ecosystems, accessory options, as well as freebies. So how do you decide?
All three brands now, Canon started it initially. You buy a DSLR and you're entitled to get a free workshop with a DSLR.
The second point is the comfort of usage.
Exactly.
Or the comfort of using.
Now again, she's confusing you. What she meant is the user interface. When you flip your camera, when you open it up, the menu, the buttons.
Okay, now you can stop talking.
Ecosystem.
Well, one way to go about it is comfort. Try it out. Kabir and I did when we purchased our DSLRs. We played with the interface, buttons and explored the features. Spent a good amount of time with the machine.
So the next point that we are considering is a bit in the future. What do I mean by that, Kabir?
Basically, we want to say that how you become a photographer from 2-3 years, 4-5, 10 years later.
Yeah.
Depends upon what kind of DSLR you want to pick up.
Yeah, it's related in a way. Yeah. How and why of it?
Because you know, it's very progressive photography. When I picked it up, I was doing portraits, but I ended up doing street photography. And you?
Yeah, I wanted to do portraits, and I just got better at portraits.
So, after portraits.
We thought photography style matters, but the expert says otherwise, and he's got a point that should matter.
More than style, your lifestyle actually dictates what camera you should get. Whether you should get a DSLR, whether you should get a smaller mirrorless camera, because which is an interesting option for people to explore. The sensor size and the brains of the camera are as good as a DSLR. So the image quality is as good as a DSLR, and they are far smaller. They're far more convenient.
While we had Raj, we also got out of him some absolute must features one should look for or not.
Firstly, megapixels don't matter. Just because the latest camera, which yes, costs 5,000 rupees more, will have maybe 30 megapixels tomorrow, it doesn't mean it's better. Second, how intuitive is the camera for you? The third most important point actually is, and it's underrated, is can the LCD swivel or not? It's very useful for somebody who wants to also do video in the future. And that's a big reality today. DSLRs can shoot very good video.
I think we've covered everything possible in this how-to, right? Except for this last bit that Kabir is going to give his little piece of advice.
Not a little piece of advice, actually. It's just that, you know, basics. If you're starting out in photography as a novice, you need to take
novice.
Care of... Okay, thanks for autocorrect Microsoft Word, Soumya.
Moving forward.
Things that you really need to take care of is that you need to have a body of the camera.
Yeah.
A lens.
Extra battery, extra SD card, batteries. Your gear, it has to be protected
tripod.
In a bag and tripod.
These are the things you really
must have for a beginner. And if you're saying, oh, you know, let me wait to buy this next model, let me wait to buy, you
never
can.
Never gonna happen,
you
like, because
can.
The technology will always, always keep on evolving.
We suggest take the plunge, pick a camera and don't miss those amazing shots you could have taken in that year when you decided not to get.
Khareed lo jaake.
Kabir! Pay attention. Okay, now I have a question for you. Do you sleep with your device?
What do you mean I sleep with my device?
I mean, you know, do you switch on the alarm? Do you like, you know, keep checking messages at night?
Oh,
so
yeah,
keep
that
the
I
device
do, yeah,
next
that
to
I do.
You?
Like, I get really angry because there's this guy on my friend list on Facebook and he gets more likes than me. Not done.
Okay, listen, put this down. Listen to me very, very closely and carefully.
Okay.
For you and people out there who are doing the same thing, not cool, not right. Mm-hmm. This is why I'm going to teach you how to not sleep with your device.
All right.
It's unhealthy.
If you're spending each night sleeping next to your cell phone, stop. Okay, I know what you're going to say, that there has been no definitive proof between cell phone radiation causing any terminal diseases, but there is proof that it interferes with your sleep cycle. So that's reason number one. Reason number two, the blue light that your cell phone screen gives off, it keeps your brain awake and it affects the quality of your sleep. And this is how you break the habit.
many of us have stopped using the conventional alarm because we use this. I'm not suggesting stop doing that, but here is a solution. Keep it away. Not only will you be forced to wake up to switch off the alarm, but your phone usage right before going to sleep will cut down, in turn cutting down on exposure to radiation. In a new relationship, can't wait to text back the person, and so you keep your phone really close to you even when you're sleeping at night? Try Do Not Disturb. The Do Not Disturb mode is available on iOS, most Androids and Windows phone running version 8.1. It turns off all notifications except from a few important contacts from your phone. It's also easy to set up. Make sure you turn the ringer up before you start to set up. On your iOS device, go to Settings, Do Not Disturb, and either turn it on manually or set it turn on and off on a schedule every day. You can allow calls from everyone, select contacts, or no one at all. For your Android device running Android 5.0, you can simply press the volume rocker and turn on priority mode or turn off all notifications. Love listening to audiobooks and music when you're... I'm gonna take that again. Love listening to audiobooks and music while you drift off to sleep like me? Well, that means you will be using your headsets and your phone will be close to you at night before you're sleeping. I suggest these. These are Bluetooth headsets and they are a great investment. Bluetooth headphones are slightly expensive but worth it if you're concerned about radiation or the effects of your phone screen on your sleep quality. Keep the phone at a distance of about 10 feet and pair it with your phone and listen to your heart's content. If you like to play a game or two or like to Facebook or tweet before you go to sleep, the best solution I have for you, schedule your tweets, schedule your status updates. The second solution, set some boundaries, guys. Let go of your cell phone an hour before you go to sleep. And lastly, do not charge it on your bedside table, charge it at a distance. Now, enough said, time for me to go to sleep. Good night.
Kabir, I'm telling you, this is not how you do it. There's an easier way of doing it.
I don't care. It's the ego.
What are you guys doing?